Hello students, good morning once again. Let's continue our chapter 16, that is environmental issues. And today's topic is greenhouse effect and global warming. The greenhouse effect term comes from the greenhouse. What is a greenhouse? Simply, greenhouse is a house which is used by the farmers who have plant nurseries in winters to provide heat to the small plants. As we know, in winter the small plants or the plants can't get enough light or heat due to which their growth reduced. So here exactly what happens in greenhouse. If we consider our earth as a greenhouse, means completely closed, and the heat produced inside it, means from vehicles, from industries, from respiration of plants and animals, and also earth receives sunlight from the sun. But here one exception. What is that exception? The earth has the ability to trap sunlight, but it can't radiate it from outside the atmosphere. That's why the temperature increases from both sides, means internally and externally. When sun's light comes here, the air activities also increases the temperature, due to which our earth get maximum heat. That is called greenhouse effect. And due to greenhouse effect, global warming occurs. Let's study about this. This is the pie chart of different gases which are responsible for causing global warming, and they are called as greenhouse gases. So how many amount they present in the atmosphere? Here is the carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide is specially called greenhouse gas. This gas is called greenhouse gas. Its amount is 60% in the Earth's atmosphere. Then 20% methane. Methane is another greenhouse gas. Here carbon dioxide is the major greenhouse gas. Next, here methane, which shows 20% out of 100%, 60% is carbon dioxide, 20% is methane. Then CFC is 14% and nitrous oxide is 6%. So they are the gases which contribute for the greenhouse gas. So how they affect? As we know, the source of carbon dioxide on Earth is different, as I have told you. The carbon dioxide come from respiration, carbon dioxide come from industrial smoke, carbon dioxide come from vehicular smokes, carbon dioxide come from aquatic organisms respiration. So they are the sources to increase the amount of carbon dioxide. Again here methane, as we know, methane is inflammable and used as a fuel in our homes. So methane gas is used due to degradation. So as we know, regular degradation of different organic materials which release methane, as well as the smokes, harmful smokes or harmful gases also contain methane. So they go into the earth, and inside the earth they increase the temperature. Next is your CFC. This is a very important and very common, which is known by everyone, chlorofluorocarbon. CFC means chlorofluorocarbon. Here, as we know, chlorofluorocarbon is used everywhere. It is used as a cooling reagent in refrigerants, means in refrigerators, ACs, aerosols, shaving gels, everywhere. We can't survive without CFC. But we, as we know its harmful effects, but still we are using this gas. And it has another nature, that it's so light that when it is released, then it directly goes towards the upper atmosphere, And as we know that our earth is protected by some layers like your troposphere, stratosphere, ionospheres, etc. So here bad ozone is formed in troposphere. Due to which it allows the UV radiation. Bad ozone is formed in troposphere due to which it allows the UV radiation to come to the earth and to harm the organisms. How? It mutates the gene due to which the persons or the organisms suffer from cancer. And good ozone is formed on the stratosphere. And we know how ozone is formed. When two molecules of oxygen is added with one molecule of oxygen, then it forms O3 or ozone. This ozone is formed in stratosphere, but bad ozone is formed in troposphere, which allows the sun's UV radiation to Earth. Again, the heat that is repelled by the Earth, as we know in summer or in spring, the sun's heat is so high. That's why after falling on Earth, Earth starts radiating it. As we know, reflection occurs when light falls on any plane surface, then it radiates. So when it get radiates, its heat is converted into infrared. Infrared means the light, the heat that is reversed by the Earth in the form of infrared, which is very harmful, and it causes ozone depletion. So here I am telling about CFC, chlorofluorocarbon. This is used in the ACs, refrigerators, aerosols and any other things. And this due to its light nature, this is so light in nature, so it directly moves towards the stratosphere and affects the good ozone. And due to which it can't protect or can't support or can't prevent the entry of UV radiation towards the Earth surface. Then your nitrous oxide, which is the major pollutant, vehicular pollutant, we have studied in last class. This is released from vehicles as well as from industries, chemical industries also. This is also a major component for causing global warming. As I have told you, greenhouse gases together combiningly cause global warming. And due to this, what happens? The Antarctica region, you must have heard Antarctica region, as we know, when the air is hot, then it moves towards the colder areas. So when the Earth's particular area, suppose Mumbai, Delhi, Kolkata, these are the area of our country, let's consider our country. Here the temperature is always remains so much high in summer. Why? Because of the pollution, because of the vehicles used and the industries are so many in this area. So the hot air goes towards the colder area, as we know the rule, goes to the colder area, and gradually it goes towards the Antarctic area, not only from India but also from the whole world. And inside around Antarctic, which is the sea, is completely covered with ice. It strikes on that atmosphere and causes ozone hole, that is called ozone hole. And the ozone hole is measured through DU. DU means Dobson unit. And it is measured that now its length is getting increased. Why? As the stratosphere get depleting, as I have told you, due to our activity. So, ozone hole is occurring near Antarctica region, and causes large ozone holes through which sun's UV rays towards the Earth. And also due to increasing temperature, the glaciers start melting, and due to which flood-like situations are occurring in many parts of the world. Not only flood, due to high temperature, some parts of the world getting desertification, means getting converted into deserts. So they are the major problems which is caused due to these greenhouse gases. And here, Montreal Protocol, I have told you here the what is the harmful of greenhouse gases. So the greenhouse gases cause global warming. And global warming is now, let's see how it causes different diseases. One is your due to UV radiation, cataract, you know, which is occur in the old age, cataract, in which a white or milky colored substance is deposited on the retina, due to which the person either unable to see anything or it may be completely lost its visual capacity. One is cataract, then another is snow blindness, then as I have told you, it causes mutation, so it may cause cancer, etc., etc. So these diseases are caused due to UV radiation, due to the greenhouse effect. So, to control the greenhouse effect, an organization that is called Montreal Protocol, remember the name, Montreal Protocol as organization, its main motive is to reduce the use of CFC. Reduce the use of CFC. But as we know nowadays, it's impossible for us to avoid these things in which we are so much habitual. We can't survive without a without an AC. We can't survive without refrigerator. So these are the some uncommon criteria. If we study now, some medicines are discovered which needs to keep in low temperature. That's why also we are using these devices. But here a substitute is discovered or substitute is invented, which may reduce the use of CFCs. Means like HFCs and other cooling agents can be used, and nowadays the newly formed refrigerators or ACs coming to market contains no CFC. If you read the booklet, then there it is written that it contains no CFC. Means the substance, the cooling agent content is harmful, but not like CFC. So this is the organization you should remember, Montreal Protocol, that is held in Canada. Montreal Protocol held in Canada, its main motive is to reduce the use of CFC and the emission of the UV ray that comes towards the earth surface. So this is about your greenhouse and global warming. And as I have told you, global warming is caused due to greenhouse gases.